pretty crazy that we're only about 2 weeks away from June.
I know.
And we're seeing these cool temperatures like this.
I just can't believe it. Winter weather at the end of May. Well, if that's something that you like, then we got a great forecast in store for you, but temperatures today not feeling too bad out there. It was noticeably warmer, up 6 degrees from what we were feeling this time yesterday. So most of the afternoon here in the valley was spent in those upper 70s, 79 degrees right now here in Bakersfield. So that system has cleared out of the region, leaving the valley, well, relatively dry, but we are tracking some scattered showers that are popping up in the mountains. Again, this is going to be light rain, nothing compared to what we were seeing earlier in the week, but you could be seeing this as we head into the next several hours, but by the time the sun sets, this system is going to be clearing out of the region, and that's going to be the case for most of your Saturday before we are tracking yet another winter weather pattern that is going to be making its way across the region, bringing another round of isolated thunderstorms as well as the chance for those snow showers. And we are tracking the chance to see those thunderstorms mainly in the eastern portion of the valley as well as into the Sierra. So that does mean that we are seeing the chance for that here in Kern County as we head into your Saturday afternoon as well as on Sunday. So by the time lunch rolls around tomorrow, you could be seeing some very light showers, and that's going to be continuing again until the sun sets, and then those are going to be clearing. And then for most of your Sunday morning, cloudy skies. But then by the time you are waking up, maybe taking the dogs on a walk, heading out to pick up groceries with your family, well, we are going to be seeing widespread showers beginning right at around 8 a.m. on Sunday. And then as we head into the afternoon hours, that's when those thunderstorm chances start rolling around. You can see that red color means we have the potential to see some heavy rain, cloud to ground lightning, gusty winds, as well as the potential for hail and funnel clouds like we were seeing earlier this week. And that is going to be continuing as we head into the afternoon hours. And then we're going to be tracking cold air on the back end of this system. So that blue and pink color that you're seeing on your screen, well, that means any of that rain could be turning into snow. That would be above 6,000 feet in the mountains as we head into your Sunday evening into early morning hours on Monday. But then the good news is the storm is going to be clearing for your Memorial Day, just a 10% chance of showers for us here in the valley. But I want to talk about temperatures, the return of the 80s for your Saturday, and then the return of the 60s for your Sunday. 67 as a high that has the potential to break that cold record high that we were tracking, something that we did earlier this week as well. So we'll be continuing to watch that. But then as that system clears, it looks like it's going to be last of that winter weather, at least for the rest of the work week next week. Look at this. Temperatures up to 87 degrees by Thursday and Friday, potential to reach 90 by that following weekend. So the Kern River Valley in the 70s tomorrow, and then 60s into Hatchpee and Fraser Park, and then cooling down just slightly. I mean, back to back to back winter weather.
Right. We're a week away from June, and we're going to see the upper 60s on Sunday.
Yes. Again, potentially breaking that cool afternoon high two times in 1 week. That'd be pretty impressive.
I know, for Game of Thrones fans, winter's still sticking around.
We love that.
We do love that.